Hello guys, been a long time since my last economics video. Been really busy doing other videos here on YouTube and posting more revision articles on my website. But just want to say I'm back and my aim is to keep posting economics videos more regularly now. So today I thought we could cover the PPF diagram. Some people know this by the PPC, but I've always referred to it as the PPF. PPF stands for Production Possibility Frontier. Let's take a look at our example for today. With all the news on North Korea going on, I thought it might be a good idea to apply this to the PPF curve. North Korea is a dictator-run state, and they allegedly spend around 22% of the country's yearly income, also known as GDP, on defense. In the news at the moment is the fact that North Korea have been producing nuclear hydrogen bombs that can be miniaturized and placed on missiles. So essentially they're able to send nuclear bombs to other countries by way of missile. Anyway, I'll go back to the point. Let's define things first. The PPF curve shows the different combinations of output between two goods in an economy. Economists use this curve to illustrate the concept of choice and productive efficiency. Let's first examine the PPF curve and figure out what it all means. First thing to notice is the curve itself. If the economy is operating on the curve, it means the economy is operating at full capacity and there is no capacity left to produce any more. You can be anywhere on the curve and you'll still be productively efficient. So that means points A, B, C, and D are all productively efficient. You may have noticed points E and F. These points are inside the curve, which means the economy is not using all of the resources available. The economy is not productively efficient at either of these points. Finally, point Z is beyond the curve. This level of production is unsustainable given the current quantity of resources and the current level of technology in the economy. We're now going to add some figures into the diagram. Have a look at point A. The amount of guns produced is 1,500 and the amount of missiles produced is 5. What happens if we operate at point B instead? If we operate at point B, we have to make a choice. We have to decide if we should give up guns to make more missiles. In this case, we have to give up 500 guns to produce 5 more missiles. This is called the opportunity cost. The opportunity cost is defined as the cost of the next best alternative foregone. Basically, if North Korea decide they want to make more missiles, it would mean that they have to give up making some guns. Notice that the opportunity cost will be constant at all points of the diagram. This is because the curve is perfectly straight. But what if the curve is not straight? What does it mean? Check out the next video to find out the answer to this question. If you want regular support from me to help you get the grades you want, why not join one of my weekly classes? It's very affordable, and I'm running some free trials at the moment. Contact me if you want to find out more.